Hello, this is Ghostlike. In part 1, the previous video, I've shown you how to download a model from HuggingFace. In this part of the series, I will show you how to do it for CivitAI. If you like the content so far, please like and subscribe. It really helps me out. Now let us resume. Now, let us try to download a different model, this time Dream Shaper from CivitAI. We will shut down the web UI here, close it, then let us go to CivitAI. CivitAI. I already have the Dream Shaper in history, so it shows up quickly. Here, let us download the safe tensor version, just to show how it's done. I'll get the link from here. I won't click here, because otherwise it would try downloading it on my own computer. We'll get the pruned version, just right click, save link as. Then what we need to do is go into the terminal. Go into the parent folder. Now we need to use wget on this. But if we tried using wget, we'd get a really weird file name. So to get from a link like the one I'm going to use properly, we need to add the content diffusion flag. Sorry, did I say content diffusion? I meant content disposition. And we also need to put the string between the URL. Let us do that now. Compared to HuggingFace, this site is a bit slower, so we'll need to wait for it to finish. This model has a big VIE, so we won't need to fiddle with putting it in by hand, like for anything V3. And it has finally finished downloading. While that was being done, I had some time to check around, and I see that on HuggingFace, if you look here and type Dream Shaper, you will see that various other people had uploaded the model to the site. So maybe downloading this 3.32 version from here might be faster than getting it from the original site. Or here, it was pretty slow, around 3 megabytes per second. While the HuggingFace is pretty fast at 100 megabytes per second. Now with that being done, let us start the web UI again. First we'll need to link the models. And I forgot to stop this particular cell first, so it queued it. Now link the models after stopping the previous cell. That took a while. Now run the web UI. The reason we needed to stop the previous web UI and the link the models is because we just downloaded a new file, so we needed to link it in the models directory for the web UI. Now we can start the web UI once again. Now we need to switch the model to the Dream Shaper. This one has the VIE baked in, so we do not need to set anything special. Now let us try prompting the beautiful girl. Beautiful. No. I set the batch size to 8. 7. 8 doesn't work for some reason. The style isn't realistic like with the regular stable diffusion, but it isn't anime either. This is the semi-realistic style that resembles Western art. Watermarks again. I could end the video here, but instead, let me create the image for the thumbnail. And we'll show you how that is done. First, we need to select one of these images. Is it this one, this one, this one? This one, this one. Okay, this one definitely not. I like this one. We'll send it image to image. Then we will upscale it. To do that, select the latent upscaler and then we will set the image size to 128, 2280 and 1280p. The denoising strength will set to something like 0.65. The optimizer should be DPM++ where Keras. Now we just need to roll it. The batch size will set it to 2. Anything more than this and we will run out of memory. Not bad. And this other one? I'll pick one of these for the thumbnail. In case you are wondering, there are different ways of upscaling, and what I have shown you is just one of them. In the following lectures, I will show you those different ways, and after that we will do some recreational prompting. I will show you how to generate the onigos, how to put in the keywords to make the image a bit better, and the general workflow for this kind of activity. I will show you some examples of my past art as well. Hope to see you soon, so stay tuned.